Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to insert footnotes and endnotes in Microsoft Word. Plus, you won't want to miss the bonus section at the end, which discusses two important benefits of using Word's footnote and endnote tools. Today, I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to Word for Mac and the single purchase versions of the software back to Word 2013. To begin inserting footnotes or endnotes, place your cursor where the superscript number for the first note should appear. Then select the References tab in the ribbon. If you're on a PC, select the dialog box launcher in the Footnotes group to launch the Footnote and Endnote dialog box. If you're on a Mac, select the Insert menu instead, followed by Footnote from the drop-down menu. When the Footnote and Endnote dialog box appears, select Footnotes or Endnotes, and then select the Notes location from the drop-down menu. Footnotes normally appear at the bottom or foot of the page, while endnotes normally appear at the end of the chapter, section, or document. You can also choose additional options in the footnote and endnote dialog box, such as number formatting, and whether the number applies to the whole document or to a specific section. When you're finished, select the Insert button to create the first note. Word will insert the superscript number in the text where you placed your cursor earlier, and your cursor will move to the note location you selected a moment ago. Now you can type your first note. You can then double-click on the number in front of the note to return to the location of the corresponding superscript number in the text. When you're ready to insert your next note, once again place your cursor in the text. But this time you can just select the Insert Footnote or Insert Endnote button in the References tab. All the options you selected earlier in the Footnote and Endnote dialog box will be maintained. Here are two benefits to keep in mind when working with footnotes and endnotes in Word. You can use footnotes and endnotes in the same document. If you choose to use both, the first type inserted will be assigned superscript numbers, and the second type inserted will be assigned superscript letters. However, these options can be changed in the footnote and endnote dialog box. If you move the footnote or endnote superscript in the text, the sequencing of the number or letters and the notes themselves will be automatically updated. Additionally, if you add or delete footnotes or endnotes between existing notes, the sequencing of the numbers or letters and the notes themselves will also be automatically updated. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlists, How to Use Microsoft Word for the PC, and How to Use Word for Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.